It is Friday, 4:16 a.m. Getting ready to go to the airport to do the conference. So I'll see y'all when I get there. Stay tuned. Go get in the line. Sit down for a second. Is my hair. Oh, I'm so tired, y'all. We ate at a restaurant called Lizard Dickens, I think. It was good. Good breakfast. Now I'm sleepy. I'm trying to wake up.
Tell
the vlog, hey.
You didn't get in it.
Y'all supposed to say, hey, it's a video.
Hey. Michigan, Columbia, South Carolina, permission to be ballers from God.
Yep.
What are you
thinking to? All right. I'm walking up. It's mine. I'm going to see it.
Hey, you should have an okay. You guys, like this, it's not over. You got to
leave.
They're
getting revved up.
Oh, it's getting longer.
I know.
Oh my God. Are you lucky? Like
they doing a giveaway.
Oh, you need to get in?
No.
Oh, yeah, I'm lucky.
Here we go.
I know.
I know.
Oh, you done. When I park outside of my house, so I always have to space for my feet. Yeah,
So we're getting ready to go to the big part.
First of all, just thank God for this environment. Not every environment can facilitate transformation, but it is increasingly clear that this is not just a room, this is a womb. And I don't know what came into this room, but I feel like God's going to birth something before this conference is over. That you're not going to leave this place the same way that you came in. I wish I had about two or three women who would sitting next to. You might just be sitting next to somebody who will push you And I've been praying. And I asked God who would be in this room. I want to go on a journey with you. With the expectation that when you leave this place, you won't be the same. With the expectation that when you leave this room, that strongholds will be broken. That the thoughts that you couldn't lay captive on, that God's gonna arrest them right here in this room. I don't know who you are, but I feel like God's got something He wants to breathe into your spirit. If you would indulge me for just a moment, I wanna read my passage. I want to share with you what God has been sharing with me. Can you help me thank God for the gift of Pastor Travis and Dr.Jackie? South Carolina, but the moment I touched down in this city, I felt like there was a great revival coming to this city, and that God has chosen this people and this generation to be affected by the revival that has started down in your life. You have to go through revival personally so that you can release revival in this city. Now everything you touch is going to be on fire. God revealed something to me when studying that I want to share with you. Now a certain woman had a flow of blood for 12 years and had suffered many things from many physicians. She had spent all that she had and was no better, but rather grew worse. When she heard about Jesus, she came behind him in the crowd and touched his garment. For she said, if only I may touch his clothes, I shall be made well. Immediately the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of the affliction. And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that power had gone out of him, turned around in the crowd and said, Who touched my clothes? Somebody's in this room and Jesus is wondering, who was it? Who touched my clothes? When you were worshiping, it felt like somebody was trying to touch the hem of his garment. And so, Spirit of the Living God, it was us. We were the ones in need of a touch from you. We were the ones who were trying to worship through worry, trying to worship through depression. It was us who was reaching for you. Spirit of the Living God, we invite you to invade this place as only you can do. God, I thank you for this divine encounter that was already appointed in heaven. God, my prayer is that we would leave nothing on the table. And we pick up every crumb of this meal, this spread of the permission conference. And may the change we experience in our soul overflow. Let it touch the people who couldn't be in your room. Let it touch our friends and our family who aren't ready for rooms like this. Let it overflow and create generational breakthroughs so my daughter doesn't have to carry the same burden I've been carrying, so my sons don't have to battle the same things I've been battling. God, we give you permission for generational breakthrough. We just pray that it would begin with us. God, I thank you for the spirit of wisdom, revelation, prophecy that you would allow me to see in this room, but that you would flow through me. No nerves, no anxiety. Just your spirit, your words flowing through me. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
You have to let some things go. And I can't think of a better place than this altar to lay down what you've been carrying, but what is now carrying you. It's been hard being you, but God's still been with you. It's been tough to survive, but the grace of God was still chasing you. Goodness and mercy still been following you. It followed you into depression. It followed you into the bar. It followed you into the drug. It followed you into the addiction. Goodness and mercy said you can't go nowhere where I won't follow you. There's not a lover in the world that can turn me away from you. Goodness and mercy is still chasing.
Thank you, God, that even at this altar, healing is coming to a woman. for rest. I thank you for peace. I thank you for joy coming to her heart. That when it's all said and done and they ask how she made it to the other side, that she'll say, my faith has made me. Oh God, I thank you that she's going to be a monument for your glory. A beacon of light that changes not just her family, but everything connected to her. I thank you that no weapon formed against her must prosper. I thank you that angels go ahead of her and make her clear path straight. I thank you for that winter protection that's over her life. I thank you that she's just getting started.
Or to the right, we could only look to the hills where our help came from, where our help comes from, and where our help will come from. And so even in this matter of life expectancy, I remember I had a lot of death going on around me, and I remember God said to me, just continue to look to me. Take it moment by moment, day by day. He is the author of time. And time is so beautiful because someone is praying that time will speed up, and someone else is praying that time would slow down. But the keeper of time, he will take time and make it work for all of our good.
Y'all stay tuned, amen? We can't do it yet. It's got to be a whole thing, okay? Amen, amen. As I get myself away from this apple juice, amen. God, thank you.
Insecurity, over feelings of unworthiness, over feelings of being rejected by people, but really feeling rejected, God, by you. And I pray, Lord, that you would heal the hearts and you would give them eyes to see who you see. That they would look in the mirror and they would just see what God sees in them. God, I pray for those who feel like they have already made two mistakes in their impatience, that they would not feel disqualified. God, I thank you that you have come for them, and I pray that in Jesus' name, that this season as they wait would not be a barren or fruitless season in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And I pray, Lord, by the power of the Holy Spirit, that the devil would not be able to use their singleness to distract them from the purpose of God that is right in front of him. Jesus' name. So I, God, I pray you would forgive us for the moments that we have been so blinded by that desire that we have missed what's in front of us. And I pray in Jesus' name for the scales to come off of their eyes, for them to see what you have for them this day, this ground that they stand on, that they would know this ground is holy in Jesus' name. And I thank you, God, for helping them to understand that, well, maybe they feel ready, that God, that they would give you the freedom to get their spouse ready. And they don't trust you to go, God, I don't want him before he's ready for me. So I pray, God, for hope to arise in Jesus' name, where despair, where they have started to just not even want to hope anymore because they're so tired of being disappointed, in Jesus' name, breathe a life into the dream and to the desires of their heart, God. Set them free to trust you again, to believe you again, to stand on your word again, to seek you for your voice again, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The Father said, in meekness, you have the right to hold me. The question is, will you lay it down or lay it down? And so I said, yeah, I want to. It's almost, once you feel empowered, then you feel the freedom to be persevering, right? But sometimes we don't give ourselves that time to be empowered in the presence of the Father. Even we need those moments to take a pause, to be empowered to release. Does that make sense? Because I told someone, God is aware of my Monday. See, after I was released, you hear me? After I would have released, had I not been empowered in my story, I would have dealt with regret on Monday. And God was already in my Monday. He was like, when Monday comes, I want you to be confident that what you said you wanted, you chose it.
Yes, I'm getting me some seafood.
before she stood at that door and it opened. She cries out because she's broken. Keeping up with the Joneses is never ideal if you can't be real about where you are and how you feel. She said, I never intended to cover up for a second. I just wanted to be accepted. Covering up the insecurities of my adolescence in designer because coping became better than the pain you feel being rejected. Then the voice in the mirror, it interjected. It said you never needed acceptance. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. God knew you before conception, and your life is the proof that if you believe in yourself with God, you will never lose. So go back to that door, and this time take God with you, because your status has changed, and your name too. You've been marked as free indeed. So understand, my sister, you are always worthy of any invitation you receive. Do you accept?
God has made them long before. And so I'm going to come to you today with this word and believe God to bear much fruit. If you don't know me, I want to just thank you for listening to me. Thank you. Just consider me your light-skinned sister. I know. You already know you're coming to the light-skinned session, but here we go. But I'm just going to be me, okay? That's all I know how to do. I'm not nobody else, and I'm a Bible teacher, so in a moment when I'm going to read a lot of scripture, and you're going to deal with it, because you're stuck here anyway with me, and I think you're going to love it, okay? We're going to read a lot of word in just a moment, but I want to just say thank you for leaning to me and listening, even though you don't...
Thank you.
about 8:30 p.m. I know I said I'll see y'all at the airport, but I forgot to close out the vlog. I was just so tired. We left the conference probably at like after 11, and we didn't go to bed till like after midnight. We had to be up and at the airport by 3:30 so we can return the rental car and get checked in and all that. So I really didn't end the vlog at the airport like I said, but I got back to Huntsville probably at about 8 a.m. and now it's like 8:30 p.m. So don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Let me know how y'all like it, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye.